大丈夫ですね。で後半のお話をこれからいたします。でこれはあの研究の方なんですが、まあ、あのフォローイングフットマークをリサーチで、まあ、表面やナノ系の話が多いんですが、これがあの私のこれまでの研究の、まあ、一覧のリストです。 So、this is the research topics by myself、started、theory of random systemsThis is Dr. Tesi's work, and then surface structure and electronic states, and the development of novel computational methods like DB, X-alpha method, first principle density functional program package. This we have developed rather earlier PIO, and also recursion transfer matrix method for very non-equilibrium state.And real space finite element method and quantum electrodynamics calculation method, so on. And then surface dynamics with electron transfer and physics of clusters and theory of STM. STM is an abbreviation of scattering tunneling microscopy and the theory of carbon nano structures and theory of AFM and Kelvin probe force microscopy.And nanostructures and molecular devices and solid interfaces. So let me start for the STM AFM Kelvin probe force microscopy part. And I felt very various puzzles.From the successful experimental good, results. And from this puzzle, we developed a theory for this SPM experimental method. So first question is that tip, so the curvature is almost several nanometers, much larger scale than atom size.But atoms can be imaged. Then what and how does SPM see the surface? How atom scale information is transferred by the macroscopic devices, cantilever and tip. So effects of local force or displacement of this proximity regions.And fluctuation temperature effect. And for the case of tunneling current measurement, wave or particle like nature, or quantum coherence problem. And of course, the major interest is effect of the tip atomic structure or atom current.And I think it's really needed theoretical basis for that. And once established this very fundamental physics of these, then we can further develop the SPM technology to the observation of very quantum phenomena or the functionalization of the total system. And we can, of course, make formation of atomic.Atomic scale artificial signal. These are already after 1993, Tom Aigra has made this. This is an individual iron atom on the kappa plane, and this is very, very amazing experimental result. But this can be done only very low temperatures, and later.Japanese physicist, Professor Morita's group made it on the semiconductor surface by AFM, and this is stable even in loop temperature. So, anyway, the theoretical, very exact theory of the tunneling current, we have developed that theory. So, this is the final result.Of the tunneling current at the position site R and bias voltage V is expressed in such a way Here is J is a hopping matrix element between the site and site J. And this is a so-called Green's function that describes electron quantum propagation from the site J to site J prime. And then it goes back to the tip, surface, and at the surface they propagate with the surface Green's function like here. So this is just the equivalent formula, tip, either tip and the surface, which is a tip, which is surface, not discriminated here. So this must be required for the theory of STM. And so this is an example for the image of the porphyrin. And here we see some significant difference for the model of the tip with or without 5D occurrence of the tungsten. So such things can only be explained by such kind of exact. And this is another case of the silver absorbed on silicon root 3 by root 3 surface. And this is experiment, and this is theory, and the theory reproduced quite well experiment. But here, important thing is that this bright spot does not mean any of the atoms, but this is just such regions, so in between the top atoms. And this is this maximum amplitude portion of the lowest unoccupied state. So this means STM is governed by very, very quantum mechanical processes. So the same surface can be imaged with this tip in such a way. This is very different, this and this. This is imaged by this type of tip, but this is an image obtained by this. So quite different, but if we tilt the tip, so direction as a little bit, tilting, then we recover this image. So this means tunneling current is concentrated only very so narrow atomic scale regions. So this is a theoretical confirmation of this. So about several years after, we developed a new theoretical method to calculate non-equilibrium situation, and current distribution can be calculated. And so with this method, we obtain in such figure, this is tunnel current distributions between aluminum tip and silicon surface. And as you can see here, this current is very much concentrated on this apex regions. And if slightly moved to this tip, then the current is some wavy line, but the localization of the current is also confirmed. So this is a more recent result, cooperated with Shitotsugi Sensei's group. This is a determination of very strongly deconstructed strontium titanate surface. And this is an experimental STM image on this surface. And this is a simulated STM image. It is somewhat recovered. And this is a STS image, experimental image, and theoretical simulated image. And the agreement is satisfactory. So we have some confidence that this very much distorted structures up to the four atomic layers dramatically different from the crystal bulk structures. This is a result of the first principle type calculation. It's quite drastic difference, but from looking at these agreements, consider this would be correct result. Now, a different example is the graphene edge. So, graphene is a zigzag edge or armchair edge, and both, this is an experiment, and this is a simulation. And we can see at the zigzag edge, much more electrons is located around the edge region, but in the armchair, not so much. It is quite a big difference. And the reason of the big, sort of strong vocalization of electronic state here is due to this so-called flat band state appears only for the zigzag edge. So STM is useful to get very detailed information of the electronic state, not only the atomic structure. So this is, I have already spoken this. This is silicon root 3 by root 3 surface. So this one, experiment and the theory. But in the atomic force microscope image, the same surface seems different images, quite different. And this is our simulation, and the simulation somehow reproduces the experiment. So, in more details, the AFM image is quite temperature dependent. This is for the room temperature. This is for lower temperature. This is this is experiment, and for room temperature and very low temperature. So this temperature dependency is rather strong, and the theory also reproduces. This is due to the surface atom, so other area is just summary fractionating effect. So anyway, the theoretical simulation is quite useful to describe surface features. So this is quite a different systems of tubulin filament. This is a protein filament structure. And this is an experiment, and this is the theoretical simulation. And this is case of the DNA experiment and the theoretical reproduction. And we can estimate so the sharpness of the tip by comparison of these areas. And this is so muscovite micas surface in water. And we can, so experimental people can measure the microscopic or atomistic fluctuations of force distributions, and the theory also reproduces these features. So the AFM is also very, very useful measurement tools. Even for the, not only for the vacuum, but also for the liquid, and also biological systems. Then this is the final topics of the SPM, that is the KPFM. Kelvin probe force microscopy is a very powerful method. And it can measure so charge distribution or the local so dielectric properties. And in KPFM, the experimentalist measures so local contact potential difference. The contact potential difference is achieved by minimizing electrostatic force in the T-pad sample. But they are rather macroscopic quantities. So contact potential is a difference of Fermi levels. But what means local? This is not not so simple. But anyway, we have made some theoretical understanding of this. So in this method, we have prepared very special theoretical device. That means we made calculations by fixing the charge transfer between the tip and the sample surface as a parameter. This quantity is fixed, but otherwise, the both systems, electron states are calculated by the first principles level self-consistently. And we can measure the total energy or Fermi level difference or force between the two by fixing this parameter. And after we change this external parameter little by little, and finding out the minimum electrostatic force. Then this is a local contact potential difference. I show only for the reserve. This is a case of silicon bubble centered 4x2 surface. For the tip height is rather closer, more higher, more distant. And this is the image of the local contact potential difference calculated in the previous slide. If impurity, in this case aluminum matter, is embedded in the fifth layer here, then this so deep located impurity can be imaged by the local contact potential difference, like here or like here. And this is the case of aluminum. And for the case of phosphorus atoms, on the same position, the image also obtained for the deep embedded impurities, but the darkness or brightness is reversed. So this indicates the difference or the reversion or reverse of the charge state. This is negative or this is continuous. So this is the strength of the Kelvin probe force microscope. And based on such method, we have developed with companies, AAAS advanced algorithms, this somewhat commercialized this software, the SPM simulators. If you are interested to use so any of this, please contact this company. Then we change our topics from the carbon nanostructures and molecular bridges. So the important thing of the carbon nanostructures is so-called discrimination, in this case, five-member rings. Based on the Euler theorem of the mathematics, so closed cage structure should have 12 five-member rings, within normal six-member rings. So this is also for the C60 case at the cap of the carbon nanotube. So this is one side. One side should have six five-member rings. And this is our calculations for two cases. One has a six five-member ring here. Or in this case, one is on the top. The other is the sun. So we have found that some very strong charge reorganization. So in the five-member ring, the center should be very negative. But so neighboring side is become positive. And we have also interested in the so-called field emission microscope. And this is experiment. And we can see this shows very clearly five-member rings located around here. So we can now know how this is explained. And such a five-member ring, or the more example is a seven-member ring, four-member ring, eight-member ring, and so on, is called discrimination. And in the discrimination, electron cannot receive scattering potential because even at the defect site, this has three nearest neighbors, and the carbon potential shouldn't be changed. So electron does not feel scattering potential, but feels this defect. How then it feels the effect? By the way, this is how we can so geometrically introduce five-member ring. So we made this 60-degree sectors and remove one and stick the remaining part each other. Then we have the five-member ring at the center. In the case of seven-member ring, we cut one sector and insert the one more sector here. Then we have a seven-member ring at the center. But anyway, the important thing is that the local density of state of the distribution shows the very much different from the normal six-member ring size. Then how electron field the discrimination? So this is a so-called Green's function, and the density of state can be calculated in such a way using this Green's function. So this is a diagonal site on the site I state, and this is expanded in the moment, and moment m's moment is calculated. So the matrix element of m's power of Hamiltonian in such a way. So this means, so if we take only the nearest neighbor interaction T, Hopping integral T, then this equation means the number of paths with m jumps starting and terminating, retiring at the site I. サイト i から出発してまた i に戻る n 回のジャンプで戻るような その道の数です これをここにかけて この m を t の m 乗をかければ このモーメントが出て それで状態密度は計算できます本当は e が非常に大きい時に計算するんですけども それを解析接続して バンド 内に持ってくると状態密度 で、このパスの数はですね、この絵を見ていただくと分かるんですが、we can see that if the binding number of the pass is zero, no binding, then it's, the value is the same, even in the discrimination case, or no, perfect result case. But if the binding is taking place, then the number is different. For the case of this without discrimination. One of the interesting applications is so-called helical structure of single wall carbon nanotube. This is a development map of the carbon nanotube. It's just a parallel line. But if we remove this diamond shape here and remove inside, and stick together both sides, then we obtain five-member ring here and seven-member ring here. And in such a way, we can construct this helical tube structure. So this we have made ourselves by paper. And the important thing is that this topological properties. So in this development map, we have five-member ring and seven-member ring, so on. And if we start Kepler patterns starting from each corner, then the Kepler pattern starting from this and this sometimes agrees, but sometimes do not agree and have so-called phase on right. So this distribution of the defects is related with a phase-on line pattern. And this phase-on line pattern also just correspond to the classification of the structures of the energy band structure of this helical chain, helical carbon nanotube. So this case is very, very interesting, and we should look at this. So this is extended figure, and this is very unique because we have occupied band and unoccupied band. They are sticked in the large area of the premium. So this structure. So this is somewhat very much extended figures of energy band of this helical structure. Then if we cut both sides and remain only six unit of the helical structure, then we have such kind of torus, but donut shape. And in the donut shape, energy band is not more, no more curved, but some discrete point. This is pi over 3 or 2 pi over 3 or so, and the energy levels are like this. And if we apply magnetic field on the hole, then the allowed K value shifted uniformly to a certain direction. Then in this case, it shifts to the positive side, then this state lowers down, and these states are going up. So that means electron number is increased in this K positive region and decreased in K negative region. This means this circulating, large circulating current around the hole generated. So this is, from this we can conclude that we should have a giant orbital paramagnet. Some experimenters said that we have found such phenomena, but it's not quite experimentally sure. But this is some theoretical predictions. And also, we have found interesting features of the carbon nanotube junctions. Both metallic two junctions is joined by putting one pair of seven-member ring and five-member ring. This is a development map, and we put here the seven-member and five-member point discriminations. Then we can calculate theoretically the conductance, electron conductance. And we have found very interesting scaling rule. We have calculated more than 5,000 different junctions here. And we found that the conductance value is quite, come to the single curve. That is a quite nice scaling rule. It depends only on the radius ratio. And this reason can be understood if we make more analytical analysis. In this case, if we make KP perturbation theory, the wave function around this region is completely solved using Bessel function and Neumann functions. And from this, we can say that this is almost expressed in such a way, only by the, this depends only on the radius ratio. So this is another interesting example of very large loop current flowing inside the cage structures of carbon. So at the resonant, near the resonant tunneling conditions, so if we can put source side and drain side by the molecular bead chain or atomic chain, then we can flow in electron inside the, in this case, spheroid, and going back, removing back current. Then at that case, we have found very large internal current is flowing, maybe several tens larger than the source drain current. And this is another example of the very tiny fragment of graphene, the smallest one here. This is called phenyl molecule, and this is somewhat larger molecules. But so every time we consider, we have found rather larger current than the source drain current inside. Of course, this is near the resonant tunnel regions, and if we consider big one, it is more than 4,000 carbon atom fragment of graphene. Then we have large current distributions. The inside current distribution can be described here, and surprisingly, this distribution is just almost the same if we put magnetic field on this molecule and then calculate current distribution. Then we have almost the same current distributions. And then, we will come to the molecular junctions. And we are interested in the most, so this limit of the small devices using molecules. And the current flow or spin flow or energy flow, can be controlled by the external method, external conditions, and this would be mechanism of the molecular devices. And in this case, I think the most important point is that there are two different regimes of the current. One is a coherent current. This is very quantum mechanical. So electrons propagate like waves, and in this case, phase is very so defined quantum numbers, but the electron positions, or numbers of electrons in the molecule, is ill-defined, not defined. Or the other limit is incoherent limit. In this case, phase of electron cannot be specified. This is ill condition. But the electron position, the number of electrons that the molecules, is a good quantum number. So there are competition between the two because there is uncertainty principle between the phase and number. So anyway, how so these two regimes should be done? It's very interesting discussion. And so anyhow, if the electrons interaction with the environment is the electromagnetic environment or the some so phonon-like oscillations interaction would be so cause of the decoherence and the electron goes as the classical particles. But anyway, let us more consider about the coherent regime. So this is a very famous experiment of the so-called quantum conductance. If ball tip is once touched with the ball surface, then they are retracted. Then finally they are so this broken. But just before this broken, the quantum conductance feature is observed. This staircase unit is 1, 2, 3 the times of the so-called quantum coherence. So this means electron flows here very quantum mechanical way, and that's a cross-sectional plane, and this waveform of the electron is fixed. So this corresponds to the number of channels. And the similar thing is can be reproduced by surface calculations. And here we have also noticed some interesting features. If we bend the atom change like here, then we have found so local current distribution shows very circular loop current here. And this is quite quantum mechanical behaviors, but it, so because this contradicts with Ohm's law. So another interesting feature is a dimensional crossover of this tiny part. So this is a free electron, so-called gerium systems, connected with a pair. And in this case, so conductance shows this quantum mechanical, quantum conductance stepwise behavior. And the density of state is looks like one-dimensional energy band density of state. And if this so bottleneck becomes stronger and stronger, then this changes continuously here. So this is one-dimensional feature, but this is zero-dimensional feature. In this case, electron is transmitted with so resonant tunnel here. It is very remarkable, even though this width is very narrow, but this height just recovered to the quantum conductance values. So the same thing is also observed by the theoretical model calculations. This is a so-called tape porphyrin case. So number of the porphyrin unit is eight in this case. And we found this conductance spectrum like here. And we can see very spike-like features. And this is just shows very quantum so resonant tunneling scheme. Although experimentalists unfortunately not to be done, but this is a theoretical prediction. And then what happens if the interaction between the external environment becomes significant? Then, as I have already said, the number becomes a good quantum. Number of electrons at the molecules becomes a good quantum number. Though phase itself is ill-defined, not a good quantum number. So in this case, we can see that the electron transfer is taking place by changing molecules, ionized state or neutral state. So repetition of the changing of neutral, ionized is the mechanism of electron transfer here. And in this case, the most important thing, electron is transmitted between the two as a particle. So electron charge is transmitted in the very instantaneously. That means if the electron transfer, then electrostatic energy increases finitely. So the electron cannot be jumped if the bias property is very weak. So we can see here stepwise feature of the current against so versus voltage. So this model, for example, is quite equivalent to this circuit. So double capacitance models. Or in the molecular bridge case, this one is almost, so physical essence is the same. And we can see so the famous Coulomb blockade. This is called Coulomb diamond. And at the corner, in this shaded region, electron cannot transmit between the two because of the abrupt change of the electrostatic energies. So, and quite a recent experiment has found further interesting features. At the Coulomb, edge of the Coulomb diamond, so around here, they found such kind of fine structures. And this corresponds that the electron make transitions between the ionized state and the neutral state and between the vibrational radars. So this line shape, so parallel shape line showed this energy difference between the radars. And so this is the evidence that the electron is transmitted in this system as not as quantum waves, but as classical particles. And we have reproduced such features just concerning. So this case molecule is C60, and the electrode is gold. And we calculated the potential energy surfaces for the neutral state and the ionized state, and calculated the vibrational radars. And based on this, we make master equations for the transitions. And finally, we calculated conductance map, right here. And this is an experiment by Hirakawa's group, and this is our story. Striker can be seen, just reproduce experiment. And if we cut around here, then we obtain this spectrum. So in this case, we also succeeded to reproduce experimental features. But it is quite interesting, in some cases, electron behaves as waves, and in other cases, electron behaves as particles. How this would be termed? だいぶ長くなりましたので、この辺で終わりにして、詳細は省きますけれども、It may be better to stop here. Extended topics may include these things. Whether an electron behaves as particle or quantum waves in particular system, what and how is determined? Interaction of electron with external environment is crucial. So decoherence process. And this feature also related with quantum mechanical measurement problem. And The another topic is somewhat larger molecules. Electron behavior, depending on the space-temporal scales, changes from the quantum propagation to the classical propagations. This is also interesting. So anyway, I must stop here. So thank you very much for your kind attention. Thank you. Maybe I should make some conclusive words. I'm sorry, a few slides. maybe only in the English. The period of WPI grant was terminated last year, but as a core institute for the designated national university, as an executive organ of research university reinforcement and promotion scheme, and as a member of WPI Academy, new stage of AIMR already started. It is really a very wonderful development. Congratulations. I always admire Kotai Sensei for excellent steering and leadership on research, and management. I wish to express my most profound esteem for the effort of all the researchers and administration staff, in particular, Ikeda Sensei and Sato-san, former deputy administration director. Counting from the initial launching time of AIMR, or even from the starting time of the next stage, Director Kotani, a number of researchers and administration staff left AIMR, and with wonderful new members, a new epoch of AIMR has already started. I admire AIMR for its ever-continuing rebirth, like Phoenix. So, Phoenix のように再生していく様子を実に素晴らしいと思っております。So, with nine staff members at the administration office, these are various occasions of leaving day ceremony of administration staff. And I like wild party very much. Thank you very much.